In 2014, ISIS forced Christians out of the city of Baghdad, which in Iraqi is known as Karakash. When they took it back in 2016, this is what they found. ISIS abandoned the city, leaving the walls covered with terrible messages directed at Christians. This priest remembers one in particular.
They say, you have your leader that he's in Vatican. He cannot do for you anything. Don't think that. Other things, well, it isn't the translation very good, but I don't remember the words.
They also found the Church of Al-Tahira, the Immaculate Conception, converted into a firing range. But when the Pope arrives here, he will see a very different sight. Thanks to organizations like ACN, Aid to the Church in Need, the church has been rebuilt. The project was scheduled to end in May, but with the Pope's upcoming visit, they managed to complete it sooner.
None of us imagined that there would be this chance for the Iraqi, or especially the Christian, especially the Karakoshian people from Baghdad, that it will happen that. Like father visit their son, that really they need to see their father.
The Pope will spend only a few hours in this city of 23,000 residents, and where 50,000 people lived before ISIS arrived. They expect to welcome many people from surrounding towns for the Pope's visit. But the church holds less than 1,000 people, and they fear security measures will prevent people from seeing him up close.
Most of the people, they watched the Pope when he were around the people and among them. So they are imagining the picture will be the same. For the people, they will change. Like an example, when I meet him, I take a decision to change my name. So I took Francis, like my father.
They told us he will come in the entrance of Karakosh by car to the church. And we asked them if they can use the car of the Pope that he used, the white one, you know. I don't know if it's, there is a special name for this car, to be open and the people can see it directly. They told us, no, we cannot do that.
People say the Pope's reception will look like Palm Sunday. In recent weeks, a team of 200 people has been preparing the streets of Baghdad for the historic event.
Also, there is a decorated with the flags of the two countries, the Iraqi and the Vatican flags.
We need to do for Iraq, of course, many things to be a country of peace. And of course, the important thing is to save the Christianity in this country. Because really, we are in the time that it's very, very difficult. And if it will continue like that, of course, there will be no more Christianity in Iraq. And this is so sad.
For Iraqi Christians, the Pope's visit is a celebration, but it doesn't overshadow their struggles. Christians are in danger of extinction in Iraq. Of the 1.4 million Christians in Iraq in 2003, only 250,000 remain. It's a story of hardship in a land with biblical roots.